Welcome to State and Fig, located in historic La Arcata Plaza in downtown Santa Barbara.
Our menu focuses on products that are raised in the state of California, inspired by the flavors of the Riviera.
And we are proud to be sponsoring this program.
Hello, I'm Twyla Kim. I've been an artist and hairstylist in Santa Barbara for 20 years. I personalize color, design, and precision haircuts for each individual at Zico Salon in Montecito. I'm happy to be sponsoring Get Conscious Now.
I'm attorney Gregory Love. I will prepare your trust, bankruptcy, divorce, conservatorship, probate, evictions, all of this I can do at an affordable price and with caring. Thank you very much.
When I was growing up as a kid, I used to go around with him and watch him.
My mother and I both worked at Lowry Field.
To keep on doing this together.
I'm Patricia DiOrio, and this is Get Conscious Now, the television show that informs, inspires, and reminds us that we are spiritual beings having a human experience, energy beings in physical form. This show also emphasizes this amazing power we have to create our reality, and we're doing it with our thoughts and feelings. In fact, quantum physics tells us that we're creating our reality all the time, whether we know it or not, or like it or not, we're creating our reality. So it's very important for us to be aware of what we're thinking. When we're not aware of what we're thinking, we're creating our world by default. When we're aware of what we're thinking, we create our world deliberately, and our thoughts are a reflection of our greatest heart's desires. So this show is an opportunity for us to become present to our true nature and our power to create our world. If you'd like to look at the shows that we've done prior to this is our eighth show and our first season and our eighth show, and you can go to our YouTube channel, Get Conscious Now, www.youtube.com, Get Conscious Now, to view our prior shows. I love doing this show for many reasons, but one of the most important ones is I get an opportunity to co-host it with a great guy who drives all the way down from Napa to play with us. He's Stu Zimmerman, bright, witty, and always present with a conversation about consciousness, and I'm sure he has some wonderful words of welcome for you today. Hello, Stu.
Hi, Patricia. Thank you so much for lovely introduction and introducing our audience to the program again. Yeah, so welcome, everybody. Get conscious now. Let's start with the now for a moment, shall we? Before the program, we all got conscious together into one field of consciousness simply by taking a breath together. So I'm inviting you right now to take a breath with me, with us, whoever we are here, and just to open yourself up even more to this conversation. So are you ready? On a count of three. One, two, three. Here we go. So Get Conscious Now, as Patricia mentioned, is very much about us being energy beings, about us being spiritual beings in a human form. And we're going to have a great guest with us today that Patricia will introduce in a moment. We're also going to have a wonderful Stu's Views in a little bit, where we get to mix in, I did my best to create my own reality at a clothing optional hot springs with other people there. And I'll give you a little tease. You got to wait till see the end of the program where my section comes up, the Stu's Views, to really get the full story. But suffice it to say, I chose the option of no clothing, okay? Just to let you know. But more about that later. In any event, thank you so much for joining us and joining us in this conversation of how we can awaken to a greater truth of who and what we really are, specifically so we can love life even more. Patricia, why don't you introduce our guest,
thank
please?
Thank you, Stu. That was lovely. So when we're aware that we have full responsibility for creating our world, then it's only logical that we would create our world deliberately with the kind of thoughts that are going to be a reflection of our desires. When we don't do this, then we create our world by default, as I mentioned early on. it's not as easy as it sounds. When we have a thought and we put it out into the field, it doesn't always happen. This is not always the case, because we have these programs in our subconscious that block us and our ability to manifest. They're imprints, programs, and belief systems that hold us back from really manifesting our greatest heart's desires. Now, according to the work of Dr. Bruce Lipton, who is the author of The Biology of Belief, we are programmed from the time of conception through age 6 by our environment, by everything that happens ex utero in our family before we're born and up to the age of 6. This means that whatever occurs goes into our subconscious program as truth, regardless of the circumstances. So what we really need to do in order for us to be conscious creators and have it be effective in manifesting our desires is to clear those limiting programs. Well, today is our lucky day because our guest is about clearing these limiting programs. He is Deepak Chari, who is an engineer and a biofeedback specialist. He has a bachelor's of science and a master's of science, in engineering. He is also the co-founder with his sister Rupa Chari of the Chari Center of Health. And Rupa is a medical doctor who is committed to integrative and preventative medicine. Deepak's work is called Perception Reframing Technology, and it's an evolution of something called voice mapping, which we're going to hear about today. And in his work, he incorporates this state-of-the-art, leading-edge technology to help people release and remove limiting beliefs because he goes right to the root cause. So we're really delighted to have Deepak with us today because he's going to share with us about his program and how this works. Deepak, thank you so much for being here today.
It's a pleasure to be here, Patricia.
Really wonderful to have you here.
Absolutely. Thank you, Stu.
So, Stu, Deepak, you want to start us out?
Would love to. Well, Deepak, yes, thank you so much for joining us because you have a very fascinating technology and the way you go about inviting people into greater consciousness. Why don't you tell us how you got started with this in the first place and the origin of the Chari Center for Health?
Absolutely. Yes, my sister, Dr. Rupa Chari, and I formed the Chari Center of Health 14 years ago, originally in San Diego. And we were there for 10 years with our center and 4 years recently in Santa Barbara. And my sister's mission is to go to the root cause of what's causing people's symptoms so that they can lose weight, balance their hormones, increase their energy, and look and feel years younger. And that's what we've been doing. And what I've been doing as a biofeedback specialist and an engineer, as you mentioned, is I'm helping to clear people's limiting beliefs that are holding them back from their highest potential. And I do this with advanced biocommunication technologies. And this whole program will help to increase your confidence, improve your relationships, and release any fears and anxieties to improve your overall quality of life and improve your business success and improve your overall happiness as a whole. So that's what I've been doing since 2005, so almost 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
So what exactly is perception reframing technology? I mean, you kind of gave us the broad brushstroke on it, but what is the precise program and how might it differ from what you've learned about the work from the voice mapping?
Absolutely, yeah. Well, the way it is that your perceptions create your reality. And you can think of your, one good analogy of this, and I have a picture of this, is an iceberg. So you can see from this picture, this is an iceberg, and this arrow is pointing to this top part of this iceberg, the really teeny part. Mm-hmm. So that you can think of as your conscious mind. And I'm going to show you another picture. Now, this is the same iceberg, but this is the bottom part of the iceberg, and this monstrosity below the water, and you can see the arrow pointing to that part. Now, that's the subconscious mind. Okay, the subconscious mind is really running the show, although we'd like to think our conscious mind is doing it, okay? Now, our perception is based on our feelings, thoughts, beliefs, attitudes, and memories, a collection of all of that, okay? You know, I'm sure we've all had these times in our life where, you know, somebody says something and we just react and go, I can't believe they said that, right? And then later on, when we analyze it, we go, God, why did I react like that? You know, I knew better than to react like that. Well, the thing is, it happened in a microsecond before you could consciously analyze it. Well, that's coming from our subconscious. That's an auto program. And that was probably created from some past emotional negative experience that happened that was stored in our cellular memory, okay? So with this program, I address not only the subconscious, but I address the conscious mind too. I don't leave any part out. And that's the amazing part of it. Now, how do I do that? I do it with voice. So why do I use voice? I use voice because your voice is the most accurate reflection of your perception. And it includes everything that's going on in your whole being. Now, this is the interesting thing. When I thought of using voice, I thought, okay, your voice is coming from your lungs and your diaphragm, which is only partially true. I actually found out that when you speak in any way, you're speaking with every cell of your body, all 100 trillion cells, from every part of your body, from your head to your toe. That was quite a revelation to me. And that was quite a revelation to me because when we have negative experiences and negative thoughts and emotional issues, those negative experiences get stored in our cells, in our tissues, in different parts of our body. So when we speak, it takes the tremendous energy to speak from our entire body. So whatever was stored in there will be communicated through our voice because it's a holographic representation of our whole being. So that's why I use voice. Mm-hmm. Now, the technology I have can actually see those subconscious limiting beliefs from your voice. It can see the intensity of those emotions and also where those emotions are stored. And also, all of those emotions carry a different musical note. I'm going to show a picture right now of an actual voice map from the program. Now, in this picture here, it's basically a pie that's broken into 12 pieces. And as I was saying, each of those pieces refers to a different emotional condition, emotional pattern, and a musical note. And the colors you see in this voice map are referring to the intensity of that emotion. You know, red is extreme and blue is a cooler one. And it also shows frequencies that are missing from your voice. Now, why would that be important? Because this is the thing. Remember how I said your emotions and negative emotions are stored in different cells and tissues of your body? Mm-hmm. Well, when you're speaking, the part that doesn't come out of your voice from all 100 trillion cells of your body is the part, those are the negative emotions, because those just stay in your tissues. Well, that's the part I can see. So with this program and technology, I send you those missing notes back to you, and that whole process helps release those stuck emotional patterns.
So now, okay, mm-hmm. So let's chunk this down a little bit. Let's kind of reframe this.
Absolutely.
Okay, great. So we're talking about the voice now carrying all 100 trillion cells, did you say?
Yes.
In our bodies are all communicating through our voice.
Yes.
Or choosing not to, as the case may be.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Okay. Now, this is not detectable to the naked ear. So when we're talking to each other, I can't tell which of your cells aren't turned on or which are hiding, and you can't tell from me just by speaking with each other, right?
Right.
Or it's where the computer Right. is able to get that full information.
Exactly.
And so it detects what's missing, represents it in a musical form?
Right, it's a musical note, yes. And in answer to your question, after doing it for many years, I've gotten to the point where I can actually notice those things. Hmm. But otherwise, you're right. The computer would find those missing notes and show them to me. Let's give an easier example for the people watching this. Think of yourself having an internal keyboard within you. You have every note in there. Mm-hmm. There's 12 notes, including the flats and sharps. If we take some of those notes off the piano, and you play a certain song, and you know the song perfectly, you're talking in your normal way, but those notes are missing, it's going to sound a little bit odd, right? It's like, yeah, mm-hmm. you're playing all the notes right, you're speaking the normal way you do, but some notes are missing, so this doesn't sound quite right. Those are the notes I'm restoring back to you. So when your body picks up those notes, the harmonics vibrationally are restored. Mm-hmm. So it helps your body to release those stored negative emotional patterns quickly and easily. And that's why this whole program and technology is different than the, let's say, conventional approach, where your conscious mind might be trying to figure it out. The little teeny part I showed you in that mm-hmm. picture before above the water mm-hmm. that thinks it knows all, you know, like the grocery list, or which we often forget. What are we supposed to get? Whereas your subconscious mind is not only running all of that, it's also running your heart, your liver, every part of your organ, thank God it's doing that instead of our conscious mind, right? Mm-hmm. Oops, I forgot to run my heart. Oops, you know. So that's, it's an infinite intelligence. So you're absolutely right. So that's a way of explaining it, which might be easier to understand.
So if the missing note then is replaced by the vibration to replace the missing note, then the emotions that are associated with that blocked emotion, or the emotions that are associated with that missing note, are released?
That is correct. Or as I call it, repatterned.
Repatterned.
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay.
You can think of your body as an entire matrix. I call it a connective tissue matrix with all the cells. And we're 80% water. And water connects all the tissues and the cells in our whole body. Mm-hmm. So essentially, when we're sending the vibrational harmonics back in the form of subtle frequencies through a biocommunication hand cradle, it'll go through every cell of your body through your hand, from your head to your toe. So no matter where it's stored in the body, it will find it and it will help release it quickly and easily.
Mm-hmm. And so once you release it, it's gone for good? Or is it something that, you know, it's good for now, but you need maintenance, tune-ups, and or else it'll just kind of resurface?
Well, the way I look at it is, I guess the onion is a good example. Mm-hmm. For every time we clear an emotional pattern, that change is actually permanent. So anything, any emotion that comes after that session that they do with me is the layer below that. And all of us have many, many layers, and some have more than others based on the environment they were brought up in and what, you know, what they may have downloaded from the past. Which brings up another point. The whole concept of this whole program is based on epigenetics. An example of it is this. If a rat tried to get a piece of cheese on a bridge, let's say, okay? Now, scientists have, you know, like to do different interesting experiments. So what they might do is electrify the bridge. So the next time the cheese tries to get, the cheese? Let's try this around. The rat tries to get the cheese on the bridge, and it's electrified, you know, the rat would get scared and say, I am never going on another bridge to get cheese ever again, no matter what the bridge looks like. Okay, so that's a fear that that rat has. Well, they found out that 7 generations later, in every single generation, all of those baby rats had the same fear of the bridge that they don't even know what a bridge is, but they will never go there to get the cheese. Well, that was the concept of epigenetics. In other words, the unresolved issues of our ancestors, like our parents and grandparents, are downloaded from one generation to the next. As I said, unresolved. If the emotional issue was resolved in a previous generation, it doesn't get transferred down. Certain percentage of the emotional issues from our parents and grandparents get downloaded to us. And that happens from the time of conception, okay? So from the time we're born till the time we're, let's say, around 11 or 12, all of these patterns have been downloaded to us from birth. And then also we have the environment we're raised in with our parents and, you know, in our environment that we're raised in. And Dr. Bruce Lipton talks about how the environment we're raised in can affect our DNA, especially at that impressionable time, because we're like a sponge at that time. We're just absorbing.
Mm-hmm. Well, one would think that if our parents, who are giving us the genetics to begin with and have their own unresolved issues, providing the environment for us, then it becomes a double whammy, basically, because they wind up reinforcing what's ever unresolved within them to begin with into us.
Exactly.
Mom and Dad.
Yeah. Exactly. Right. Thank you so much.
But where does the epigenetics come in? Because as I understand Bruce Lipton's work, you know, even though we get downloaded with these programs from our ancestors, that when we're aware of the programs, or when we, you know, when we're not controlled by our genetics, he says our genetics are a blueprint of all the possible ways we can show up in our physicality, but that our cells are actually informed by the environment. So we can actually change the cells in our body that have been programmed by our ancestors, can't we? I mean, that's what epigenetics is my understanding.
That's correct. And the other issue is that, remember that monstrosity of that iceberg below the water I showed in that previous picture?
Uh-huh.
That's running the show. So a lot of times we don't even know what those patterns are from our ancestors to even clear or be aware of.
Uh-huh.
And that's the tricky part of it, because that little teeny part above the water, the conscious mind is trying to figure all this out. And it's beyond figuring it out. It's a huge thing. And it's not logical like our conscious mind thinks. Mm-hmm. We think in our conscious mind, this happens, A equals B, and then B led to C. But actually, it's not like that in the subconscious. You know, it could be a very random sequence of events. But the neat thing is, with this program, it will unravel the way it was linked in your subconscious, piece by piece. And you don't even have to really worry about how it happens. It'll happen. It'll bring it to your awareness.
So you don't need to be aware of the pattern of the negative program that's hooking you. You just need to maybe speak about your childhood or speak about an event that comes to mind.
Yes.
While you're speaking, and this will reveal it in the technology in front of you.
Exactly. You can speak about the event, let's say, that is causing the stress in your life. It could be a current event. It may not even have to do with the ancestors, but it will lead to that. It will take us there. Mm-hmm. And so what I actually do when I work with clients is I work on the root cause in the three foundational sessions I start with of where these patterns came to begin with. Because where we are in our life and the things, opportunities, or events that happen in our life are because of those programs that were downloaded to us at birth and the environment we were raised in, unbeknownst to us. So if we can go in there and reframe it, we can and change how we view the situation and release the energetic charge of things that might have been causing us emotional issues or negative emotions, then it'll literally change our whole life in the direction we're going, because we're going to look at the world in a different way and thus create a whole new reality.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right. And so when you're sending back this energy, the feedback to fill in the missing notes, and it goes on its search mission to find out exactly where those cells are in the body that have been holding that energy and resolve it, does that change our genetic makeup? Does that change our cellular structure on a physical level?
Well, I can say on the part on the emotional level, yes, definitely. And whatever was downloaded to us or the environment we're raised with, like you said, double whammy, will get resolved, absolutely. So when the charge behind those emotional issues or triggers are released, it just becomes a memory, but it doesn't have the charge. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And when the charge isn't there, that changes our perception of those events, mm-hmm. and thus changes how we look at reality, even in our present world. Because even the experiences we bring into our own life are based on those root fundamental patterns.
Mm-hmm. It's interesting that you should talk about the charge. And one of I recently attended a workshop with Dr. Joe Dispenza, and what he says is that a memory without the emotional charge is called wisdom.
Ah.
And that would just fall right into what you're saying, right?
Perfect.
So we can remember an event that happened in our childhood, but when we don't have an emotional charge to it, then it becomes information that makes us wiser.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. And this program helps you to release that charge, because oftentimes when we try to do it with our conscious mind, the more we do it, the more deeper it gets embedded in our subconscious.
Right.
It's like it runs away from us almost.
Right.
But with this program, since I involve both the conscious and the subconscious, there's no way for it to escape. It's just going to reveal itself naturally and easily.
So you've studied with the originators, the inventors of voice mapping. Is that correct?
That's right.
And yet you have developed technology beyond what they're doing. In yours? I mean, you have enhanced your program. I guess what I'm asking you is, what makes your program different from theirs? Technology different from theirs? What have you added to it? How have you expanded it?
Well, I had the fortunate, rare opportunity to work with one of the original inventors of this amazing technology, and had some literally amazing insights into deeper ways of doing this work. And on top of it, I guess because of my background in engineering and a biofeedback specialist, I also added my own discoveries as well. And all of these things have led to amazing results, significantly huge results with our clients, mm-hmm. hundreds of clients that we've seen throughout the years. So because I've learned a lot of things with him personally and added my own discoveries as well, it's led to really significant results.
Well, what were some of your discoveries?
Well, that's basically what people will discover when they have a session with me, because it's there's too many to mention.
Okay.
Well, are there certain core issues or so that you're finding with people who come to you? There are certain, common issues that a lot of the people have?
There are some commonalities overall, but you're absolutely right. There are certain common patterns I see in people overall. You saw that circle with the voice map with those 12 different partitions in it. Yeah, there are some certain patterns I see overall. And a lot of it has to do with self-worth and
deservedness
and deservedness of where they are, So, yeah.
And that's Men and women both?
And men and women both, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Although the majority of the clients I have seen are women, I have to say. Mm-hmm. But yeah, absolutely, for both. It can change your whole way of doing things. But the other part I wanted to mention too, and this is a big one. I talked about we use voice, right, to analyze what's going on in the people's perception. This will enhance your voice significantly, because when you restore those missing notes back to their voice, mm-hmm. it's equivalent to having this huge loudspeaker covered with this massive cloth. You know, the loudspeaker is trying to communicate, but the sound is muffled. We're taking that cloth off this loudspeaker. So people are going to hear your voice in its original form, the way it was intended to be, mm-hmm. with its full power, vibrancy, and resonance. And not only that, people have also noticed, aside from their increase in confidence and improved relationships, that their words that they speak are just eloquent and words they normally, as they wouldn't have said. It just flows effortlessly. So they're almost speaking from, you know, their higher wisdom, you know, without getting caught in their conscious mind.
What I've observed in my work with you, Deepak, is that you employ your intuition. And even before the computer program is running, and I've just been speaking to you, what I've observed is that you've been able to, you know, pick up what was going on even before the computer program displayed it. So is this something that has come naturally to you, or did you have to really work to develop that intuitive muscle?
I've been doing it now for 8 years, slightly over 8 years. So after doing it for a while, I noticed that that ability started coming within me, where I could actually sense the emotions even before the computer would show it it would create a voice map.
Yeah, interesting.
So that intuitive ability started developing over that time.
Mm-hmm. And I was wondering, have you ever worked with singers, you know, whose profession it is to really have their voice be there, you know?
That's a great question, Stu, absolutely. Yeah. And I have. I've worked with a couple singers. I worked on one singer who was raised with the belief of, you know, I should not be seen or heard, which is kind of difficult for a performer, you know, not to be seen or heard. And she was going to be recording, singing at one of the largest stages she's ever done in her whole life on top of it. So she came to me. I worked on her with this perception reframing technology program. And the amazing thing is she did the best performance of her career in the biggest hall of her career and got the best response she's ever had. And she was totally confident, totally connected to the audience, and totally, you know, seeing the reactions and in the flow with it. So it was, you're absolutely right. And I worked on another woman who had actually stopped recording music, and she also wanted to be an author and also wanted to be an entrepreneur, because she was also told that, you know, she's not to be seen or heard. So that's kind of difficult for her to do that otherwise. So when I cleared those patterns in her, she started re-recording again, finished her book, and started her own online business. So that was, so absolutely, I've worked on a couple of things.
So you have quite a few testimonials.
Yes, absolutely. I've worked on some business executives as well, and it's improved their confidence. It's increased their opportunities that even came to them out of the blue, you know, that were not happening at all, reduced their anxiety to situations that previously would have really set them off. And they actually became very relaxed in all their business dealings and even all their business partners and everything. You tell them, like, you're so much calmer than you've ever been. And it was an unconscious reaction from him, like, oh, I didn't even notice that, you know. It's amazing the results that have happened. So since he's not getting triggered by things that normally would have triggered them, he's able to bring more opportunities into his life. And that's the other thing. The other benefit is opportunities seem to come out of nowhere when we do this work. That's another huge benefit. Besides improving your voice, the resonance, the strength, the confidence, and personal relationships, the opportunities that come in people's life seemingly come out of nowhere. So that's something I've also noticed.
So what's the thought behind that, the analysis that somehow we reorganize our energy field a bit through your technology? And that somehow that's a magnetism or an electromagnetic field that gets created around us that draws in, whether it's synchronicities that you're talking about or other opportunities, or people are drawn in even non-locally where they may pick up the phone out of nowhere and call. Is that just because you've shifted, your client has shifted their energy field?
Yeah. It's like this whole program will help release those limiting blocks that they're not even consciously aware of, and that was actually holding them back from those higher opportunities. It creates, because we're actually, every one of us is connected to each other, aside from the separation of our physical bodies, there's like a wireless connection between all of us. So when we clear any blockages in that wireless network between all of us, then it opens up the potential for infinite possibilities for all of these coincidences or synchronicities, let's say, to happen.
I think a big piece of it as well is that, you know, the person has dreams and visions and goals, and they're putting it out there, but it's not happening, perhaps. You know, and you clear the programs, and then because they put that energy out into the field, you know, then the opportunities will show up.
Yes.
And they'll show up in a way that they don't even expect them to show up.
Yes.
And that's what makes it so miraculous.
That's what I've been seeing. You know, here's an example. If a golfer, you know, I've seen golfers who take all of these, you know, advanced classes and, you know, all these advanced techniques to improve their game. But when they go to hit the ball, they hit it the same way. You know, even though they know millions of techniques. So what's happening there? Well, what's happening is that in their subconscious, they're at a plateau of where they can go. Your subconscious is saying, no, you can only play this well. You can only do this. So no matter what technique they learn, they're only going to be limited. So with this program, this can release that limitation within them, and then all the techniques they do will just fall in like perfectly. Another example is, let's say, a woman or a man who keeps attracting destructive relationships over and over again. And let's
say... people do that?
I don't know. I heard that might happen.
I don't know. I guess
you've been, Stu.
Yeah, I was going to say, I've been in one of them.
It's possible.
More than one of them.
Yeah. And the thing is, and these people are extremely intelligent. I mean, absolutely astute. And they'll say, I'm an extremely intelligent person. You know, why would I do something like that? Well, it has nothing to do with the intelligence. It has to do with the limiting beliefs or programs within their subconscious that are holding them back, mm-hmm. unbeknownst to them. So by doing, I have seen this happen by releasing these limiting beliefs within them that they're not even consciously aware of. Mm-hmm. Then they'll start attracting the relationship that's actually what they're really looking for.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to take a moment to talk about the ego. You know, because the ego is a part of who we are. We can't be without the ego and have the human experience. But the ego has gotten pretty much of a bad rap, especially in the spiritual conversations, so to speak. So share with us about your opinion about the ego and the ego-mind personality and its role here in this conversation.
Well, I personally believe the ego is actually a very good thing, and I know what you're referring to. I think the ego is necessary in everybody, and I think we've been told the ego is bad and, you know, that kind of thing, but then also your empowerment won't be there as well if you have zero ego. So I think it does have it's there for a reason, you know. It has mm-hmm. It has its place. There may be extremes in some areas, but it definitely is a very good thing. It's a guiding force for you. And it's an empowering force for you.
I've come to realize that, you know, it helps us navigate this world. But when our ego is running the show, which is 95% of our waking state run by the subconscious, which means the ego is driving the bus, so to speak, we're not aware of that. And it blocks our ability to really be happy and to manifest our dreams. But if we can realize the importance of the ego and know that it's a navigation tool for us, then it's about, how I look at it is treating the ego as it's a little child, you know, like a 2 or 3 year old child. Mm-hmm. We would never have a 2 or 3 year old child driving the bus, right? But we do it all the time in our life when we're lost in that 95% of our subconscious programming. So it's about really being sure that the ego is on the bus, but not driving the bus.
Exactly.
That's how I like to look at it.
Absolutely.
Right. Yeah, I mean, my analogy for that is that, you know, we are beings of light and love and this sense of purity, and the ego is more of like stained glass. And if we have a lot of muck on it, you can't see much of the light. But when you put it over the light, it can mm-hmm. shine in beautiful ways. And, you know, if everybody were identical here and just kind of being these light beings, maybe things wouldn't be so interesting. So that the fact that we're all a little different, we all bring a little nuance and difference to the table, mm-hmm. in the way our egos show up, can be a beautiful thing.
So Deepak, share with us what it would be like when a person comes to see you. What is the process? I'm sure people want to know, well, what do you do? So walk us through the process when someone comes to see you for a session.
Okay. I'm going to show this picture here, which shows me sitting across from a client. And you can see the client is wearing a headset, and they're sitting across from me as I'm looking at my computer screen. So what happens is I record the person's voice where they're talking about the situation at hand that they'd like to address, causing stress in their life. And I'm not listening really to the words they're saying, but I'm looking at the energy in their voice, okay? And I showed you the voice map earlier, right? So that's the first thing I'm going to get. And when I'm doing those three initial sessions, I'm going to look at the voice map in comparison to their ancestors. And that is your parents and grandparents. I'm going to show this other picture here, which shows the voice map that we talked about earlier, compared to their ancestors. So you, let's say that's us in the center, and then the circles around it are the parents and grandparents.
Based on what they've spoken about into the microphone,
yes,
about their families?
Exactly. So first they talk about themselves, and then they talk about each of their parents and their grandparents. And then I compare all of those voice maps to their own voice map. And what it does is it'll actually compare the percentage of matching of that emotional imprint of their ancestors to their own. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, so that's what that other second picture is showing right there. So this is really powerful because, you know, and in some cases, some people don't even know their grandparents. So some people say, well, how do you get a voice map of their grandparents if they don't even know them? Well, then I'll just have them say, I don't know anything about this particular grandparent, let's say father's father, and all the other ones. Well, interestingly enough, I've seen all the voice maps look completely different when they're talking about each ancestor that they didn't even know. Well, how could that be? Because we're not actually asking them, you know, about those ancestors. I'm getting the energy from the field about them talking about their ancestors, mm-hmm, since we're all connected. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it's their subconscious, which they're not even aware of, that knows past, present, and future, mm-hmm, that's actually being that's being recorded in the voice map, as I was talking about earlier. And that's what's revealing everything to me. So that's what I do there. And then when I look at that comparison, I can see where to start first of clearing these. I can see where these emotional imprints came to us that we're not even consciously aware of, and help clear them.
So there are never any, it's always the negative emotions that show up as the blocks. I mean,
yeah, I call it limiting emotions, absolutely.
Limiting emotions,
yeah,
right.
Exactly.
So what about the positive things that we inherited from our ancestors?
Well, the way I look at it,
they wouldn't show up in...
Well, the way I look at it is this. If it's good, then there's nothing to change. There's nothing to improve there.
Right.
So I won't see it. If there's any limiting part, that's the part I'm going to see. So that's so you get to keep all the good stuff of your ancestors, keep all the good, and release anything limiting. So it's a win-win, no matter how you look at it.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
Yeah.
Good.
Right. So then we are actually, once again, we are changing our lives. We are changing how we feel in our bodies, right? Because whether we realize it or not, these blocked energies, these limiting beliefs or blocking beliefs, have been stored in our bodies and have shaped our experience of life,
yes,
whether we're aware of it or not.
Exactly.
And so this opens up people to literally experience a greater sense of peace, right? A greater sense of happiness.
Yes.
And potentially even joyfulness.
Yes. I've noticed people's confidence go up like anything. I've noticed personal relationships improved. I've noticed people's fears and anxieties disappear. Their overall happiness in life just enhanced, like, you know, quite a bit. I've seen amazing things, you know, and like I said, with the different executives and other people I worked with. I worked on another woman who said, when she first came to the office on the first day, she said, this is the worst year of my life. I don't want to live anymore. After I worked on her, she said, this is the best year of my life. And she had no friends in the beginning when she came, and she said everyone hated her. Well, after I worked on her, and this relates to what you said, it changed her whole perception of herself. And mm-hmm, then people started pouring into her. She says, I'm getting invited to so many parties, I can't even go to them all. I was invited to the head table of some other family's party, and I wasn't even their family member. I'm getting gifts at my door that I don't even know who these people are. you know, I'm being invited to all these trips. She goes, I wasn't invited by anyone before. You know, how did this happen? So you're absolutely right. You change the internal limiting beliefs and programs that were downloaded from our ancestors and our environment as we were being as we were growing up, and your whole life and world changes. As it
so
did
we
with
are
her.
Shifting our yeah. our genetics then.
Yeah, I feel that you are. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And the people around us yes. are changing as well, yes. simply because we're changing.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. As I was mentioning, it's like a wireless effect. You know, if there was an issue with one person and another, when we clear our issue with that other person, I have seen amazing things that the other person responds,
right.
you know, in a positive way, which is quite remarkable. You know, mm. out of the blue. And, you know, so it, that happens immediately, instantaneously, the moment we clear these patterns.
Well, I wanted to mention in the intro to our audience, but I'll mention it now. I've been working with you, you know, for several months now on issues from my childhood that were pretty traumatic. And I've definitely noticed a huge shift in how I feel and my life has changed. Things are happening that are unexpected surprises, but they're definitely a reflection of what I want to have happen. So I know that based on my own personal experience that this is probably the most effective modality that I have experienced myself. And as a spiritual teacher for the last almost 20 years, that's saying a lot because I've done a lot of work on myself to shift these programs. So I commend you on the work, and I think it's really it bodes well for humanity's awakening process.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, and I've also been very blessed to have a couple sessions with you, and in conversation with you, it really dawned on me that you are like a shrink in time, because what you do is you shrink the time that it would take if you were a yes. psychologist. You'd yes. be doing this stuff forever, you know, trying to get to the bottom of that iceberg, and you're going in with the laser.
Yeah,
and mm-hmm. And it's really a beautiful thing.
So how many sessions would you say on the average it would take to really create a major change in people's lives?
Well, it varies from person to person depending on the emotional issues that were downloaded to each person. But I start out with the three foundational. I call it the foundational three sessions, and then we do follow-up sets of two sessions after that. So you know you want to definitely you know I would definitely say you know seven. You know, seven sessions would make quite a good impact. But it's also good to keep following up with that too, you know, like you said, for maintenance. Mm-hmm. Because as we clear things, you're going to get bigger and better opportunities in your life, including in your personal life and your business life. So this will help you to meet those because you wouldn't have been prepared at that time to meet them. You wouldn't have been with those previous beliefs you had. So it'll just take you higher and higher from where you were.
But it would seem to me too, and this has been the case for me, that as those belief systems were shifted, more of them started to come up from my subconscious. It's like that whole metaphor of the onion, peeling the layer of the onion. It's not just one layer, it's layers underneath that, getting right. to the core issues.
Exactly.
So although there have been improvements in my life as a result of this work, unquestionably, there's also been more and more programs that seem to be coming up for me to address that need to be shifted as well.
Exactly. Well, there's one good news to this whole part. Once we start the first session, every session after that, things clear faster and faster and faster. You can think of every session as like a perpetual motion wheel that keeps working. Every session keeps working. So the follow-up sessions go faster and faster and faster. So the way I tell clients when they come to the office is it's like a rocket that's taken off. You know, the rocket uses most of its fuel as it's breaking through the Earth's atmosphere. Mm-hmm. And the rest of it hardly uses any fuel at all. That's what those three foundational sessions are.
Oh, I see.
So that's why after those three, it goes a lot faster and easier. Mm-hmm. So whatever's there after that will clear quickly.
So how can people hear more about this work or learn more about this work? I'm obviously going to your website, which is going to be on the screen here in a moment. Are there books or other websites that you would refer people to?
Well, our website is a good start, I would say. They can start there, and they can read about the work I do there. And if they have any questions, of course, feel free to call us. You know, mm-hmm. call me, and I can help answer that.
Are there any books on the subject?
Not specifically the particular subject that I've, you can get a concept of the what we're talking about from the biology belief book that you were talking about, but not really specifically on the topic that I'm on.
It seems to me that there's a book in you about this, Deepak, huh?
Maybe it's time for that.
Yeah, it's time for a book.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, I would think that, you know, one practitioner doing this work or even 10 practitioners doing this work is just the proverbial drop in the bucket, right? It would seem to me that you would want as many people as possible to be able to help people do this work, practitioners, you know, of PRT.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah, yeah.
You ever thought of training other people?
Yeah, that's a possibility, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I can tell you one thing, I definitely love the work I do. It just is very inspiring. It's thrilling to me to see the miraculous, I have to say, miraculous changes in people's lives when I do this work. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's just, so for me, it's like an infinite energy that comes from, you know, from infinite that helps me keeps me going on this work. So, yeah.
And it also takes a rare person to hear all these strange and bizarre stories that we all have, you know, from the childhood woundings and whatever, you know, and some of them I'm sure are horrific. So for you to be able to be there and hold the space for that, I think is really a testimony to you as well as the technology.
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love doing it, and I'm always compassionate with everyone no matter what issues they've gone through, because I know that they're going to see the light at the end of the tunnel. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So where do you see this work going, you know, over the next 10 to 20 years?
Well, wherever it's going, I'm going to be there, because I started in 2005. with the original technology, and I've been there since, and I've seen all the amazing shifts and changes, and of course, as I learned some nuances that were taught to me personally, and I've added my own too. Mm-hmm. So we're, you know, I'm always on the cutting edge. We've always done that with the Chari Center. We were always like 10 years ahead of time, and we'll continue to do that. Absolutely.
I can relate. So one last question for you, and this is we end the show, the interview, all the time with asking a pearl of wisdom from our guests. So if you could sum up the essence of your work and give a pearl of wisdom to our audience over there in that camera, there they are, what would you say to our audience, Deepak?
If you want to have a life, a better life than you have right now, a better quality of life, and you want to remove those limiting beliefs that are holding you back from your happiness and your joy in your life and in your personal relationships, in your business, in all areas of your life, then I think this program would be the best thing for you. This program is for anyone, no matter basically what age they are, and we see people from 18 on up. This will improve your life no matter what you're doing and release your full potential for your full overall happiness in your life and confidence.
Great, thank you so much. Wonderful, thank you so much, Deepak. That was really great. Thanks so much for being with us today.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you, Deepak, thank you.
That's wonderful.
Thank you, Stu.
So I hope you'll enjoy the remaining segments. And now on to Stu's views. I'm sure you're going to have some wonderful witty remarks to make about...
Well, one can only hope. You know, I'll see if I can rise to the occasion.
I like the shrink time.
You like that one? That's a good one. Yeah.
Well, a shrink in time.
So we're going to go back in time a little bit to a few days ago for this month's Stu's views. And as I said in the earlier part, it had to do with my showing up at a clothing optional, dare I say, I was in my birthday suit, Hot Springs, where I noticed several things. First of all, one of the reasons why I go and why everybody there goes is to decompress and just to release stress and become more calm and peaceful. And in truly a confirmation that, as we've been talking about here, about the energetic nature of our reality, here is another piece of energetic reality. One is that when you go from a hot, hot tub that is 110 degrees to 114, you know, you can almost have a lot of compassion for a lobster, okay? And go from there into a refrigerated tub where it's like, boom, it's like a shock to the system. And you go back and forth a few times. It's almost a choiceless reality to hold on to stress. You can't. You have to let go. It's like there's no choice in it. So with that as a backdrop, and my having done the hot, cold, hot, cold, hot, cold dance, I go into this big tub, which is about 99, it felt like a beautiful bathtub, but it's actually the size of an Olympic swimming pool. And all these other people were in it. And some were couples, but mostly it was singles, and mostly they were hanging out by the edges. The idea is to be mostly in silence and to be in a meditative space. Well, I started doing a little bit of my own kind of scientific experiment to see exactly how interconnected we are, and possibly even leveraging the conductive properties of water, which we hear we're 80% of on the inside, and we know that it has conductive properties on the outside, that I just decided to see if I could just breathe a little bit, open my heart, and just really start to do a little swirl and a whirl and a dance, and just see if I could send these loving energy vibrations through my fingertips, toe tips, and potentially other extremities. And so in doing all of that, what I noticed was all of a sudden I started hearing, and people were having these amazing, it was like a unified field of delight where people started feeling interconnected with no words being spoken, and in many cases, not even any eye contact. But there was an energetic feeling that could be palpably felt. And then when I did finally open my eyes and take a look around, I noticed that some people really started to have that recognition and that smile and one of these and a thank you. And so it was felt. It was communicated. And so as we're talking about Deepak's technology that could take us all, that could take us all to another level energetically, which is so much magnetic and electronic and everything and really conducting with other people and connecting. There are many ways to do that. And I'm really inviting you in Get Conscious Now to do that on a regular basis to the extent you can and just see what happens. So with that, it's time for Quantum Quotes. Patricia?
Thank you. That's it. Very interesting story, Stu. You're a scientist in your own life laboratory there, for sure.
And I enjoy swimming in it.
Swimming in it, that's right. So I have some fabulous quotes for you today. But first I want to say that the reason why I love my work and I'm so passionate about my work is because it is grounded in science. And there's always been this very healthy skeptic in me that's needed to have a logical, linear, practical understanding of spirituality. Thank God. And it has really, really helped me over the years to come to this place of knowing beyond a shadow of a doubt that this is true, that we are energy and we are creating our reality. I recently attended a workshop, I alluded to this earlier, with a scientist that I has added to my list as one of my favorites, and his name is Dr. Joe Dispenza. He's
Neuroscience?
He's a neuroscientist. Thank you, Stu.
Sure.
He's a neuroscientist and he's a brain expert. And he's written two books, Evolve Your Brain, and the second book is called Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself. And it has been a remarkable opportunity for me to hear about his work. And now I'd like to share a little bit of it with you with these quotes. The first one is this. You cannot change matter by being matter. You must be consciousness and get beyond your ego self. You cannot change matter by being matter. You must be consciousness and get beyond your ego self. So given that we're all interested in changing our lives for the better, this is a very, very powerful statement. And it speaks to the fact that we are mostly energy and very little form. In fact, science tells us that the quantum atom is 99.99999% wave or energy, and that matter or the particle is only 0.000001% form or matter. So we're essentially we're made up of wave and particle. We're made up of energy and matter. However, the sad story is that most of us spend most of our waking state in the 1% particle and not the wave. So by doing inner work, by going inside, we focus on the wave. By going outside, we're focusing on the matter. So this brings us to a very important conversation about going within, which is meditation. Meditation is really how we're going to be able to shift these programs. In addition to doing work that we're talking about today, Deepak's technology work is very important, but also important is us going within. And our Our spiritual practice, doing a spiritual practice every single day, is critically important to our growth. And when we do our spiritual practice every day, make time for it every day, what we are doing is we're moving beyond cause and effect to the state of causing effect, which is the state we want to be in most of the time. And this is consciousness. So I ask you to ponder this quote because it will change your life, right? We cannot change matter by being matter. You must be consciousness and move beyond the ego mind. And the last quote I want to share with you in keeping with this Thanksgiving season that we're in right now is this: gratitude is the ultimate state of receivership. Gratitude is the ultimate state of receivership. So when we are in a state of gratitude for something that hasn't even happened in our lives, what are we doing? We're actually setting up the field energetically for that to happen. We're pre-paving the future energetically before it happens. So I'd like to suggest that you try a little exercise of working with a gratitude journal. Every day, I write a page in my journal about gratitude. I write five things that I'm grateful for that have happened that day, and I write five things that I'm grateful for that haven't happened yet in my life, but I'm working on happening. So this is a wonderful opportunity for you to actually give a gift to yourself by being grateful for something before it's happened. So that's it. Those are my quotes.
Beautiful, yeah, as always.
As always. So thank you very much for tuning in to our show today. We're very grateful for Deepak being here as well. He did a wonderful job. He did a great job.
Yes, he did.
And thank you for viewing Get Conscious Now. And remember, until the next time we see you.
That's right. Get conscious now.
Welcome to State and Fig, located in historic La Arcata Plaza in downtown Santa Barbara.
Our menu focuses on products that are raised in the state of California, inspired by the flavors of the Riviera.
And we are proud to be sponsoring this program.
Hello, I'm Twyla Kim. I've been an artist and hairstylist in Santa Barbara for 20 years. I personalize color, design, and precision haircuts for each individual at Sequel Salon in Montecito. I'm happy to be sponsoring Get Conscious Now.
I'm attorney Gregory Lowe. I will prepare your trust, bankruptcy, divorce, conservatorship, probate, evictions. All of this I can do at an affordable price and with caring. Thank you very much.
When I was growing up as a kid, I used to go around with him and watch him.
My mother and I both worked at Lowry Field.
To keep on doing this together.